everybody, this is Dr. Kamishwari, prosthodontist from Partha Dental based on our branch. Our branch is situated besides Chroma Electronics and also opposite to the Swami brand. Here we are having different kinds of specializations and all the treatments are done mostly by the specialists. And Partha Dental is having the largest network. Around 110 branches are present and they are situated in three states, that is Telangana, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. And most of you might be having many doubts regarding implants, that is what is an implant and when they will place implants and in which situations are in which patients it is required. So today through this awareness video, I would like to tell you what is an implant. It is the basic, basically what it is made up of and in which conditions will place those implants. A dental implant is a screw that is made up of titanium, and this titanium will be screwed or will be surgically placed into the jawbone. And this titanium material has a good biocompatibility property, so it attracts the bone around it and forms a good anchorage around the implant. And because of this good anchorage with the bone, the implant also gives good support to the crown or bridge or prosthesis that is made over it. Prosthesis is nothing but it is the artificial teeth that is placed over the implants. And implants, what are the main advantages of these implants when compared to, that is, you might be knowing about caps or bridges. So the difference between the bridges and caps and these implants is that first, mainly it improves the speech because of good support, giving good support to the crown. It helps in good phonation, that is, we can spell the words nicely, and it also improves the chewing efficiency because of its good support than when compared to the fixed or removable prosthesis. And it is also comfortable in full mouth cases, that is, in full mouth cases when compared to the dentures, that is, dentures means these are placed over the bone, and these implants will be placed inside into the bone, and on this the prosthesis is built, so they will be more comfortable when compared to the these dentures, because dentures they will be having a bone loss below the dentures, and most of the patients previously in good olden days most of the cases were done as dentures, but the dentures are having few problems like getting food lodgment below and the bone getting resorbed below the denture and looseness of the dentures. That is, sometimes the patient will feel embarrassing movements while talking or while eating. So to avoid these types of new technology, or it's already existing technology, that is implants, they will be the helping the prosthesis to fixed and this prosthesis thus helps in good chewing and also for good speech, and it is more comfortable when compared to the dentures, because here there will be no accumulation of food or looseness like that, like the dentures. And coming to the denture species, that is, if one teeth or more than two teeth are missing, also implants can be placed. And if only one teeth is missing or more than two teeth are missing, there is no need of reducing or repairing the adjacent teeth in type of bridges. Bridges, into supported bridges, we will reduce the adjacent teeth and we'll give the bridge. But in implants, there is no need of touching the adjacent teeth. Just simply we'll place the implant inside the bone and we'll give a cap over it. And it is called as implanted crown. And if more than two teeth are missing, then two implants or three implants are placed and over it, bridge is given. In full mouth cases, total in upper total of around 10 to 12 and in lower 8 to 10 implants were placed, and over that a hybrid process, a fixed process will be given to in full mouth cases. And can we place implants in all cases? Yeah, But mostly the bone and the gums around which the implant should be placed should be healthy, and also the patient should maintain good oral hygiene after the implant placement. And in medically compromised patients like diabetes and hypertensive or any other systemic diseases, first, before the implantation, the patient should take a consultation with the general physician, and also the sugar test should be done. And if it is under control, even a diabetic patient can be given the implants. And in case of a chronic smokers, after the implantation, the patient should quit the smoking habit, because the tobacco content can eat away the bone around the implant and cause peri-implantitis. This is the implant can be loosened because of those habits. But implants can be given in all conditions. But priorly, the patient should maintain good oral hygiene and also frequent visits to the dentist. So, my friends, I would suggest you to go for a fixed process rather than removal, because of nowadays chewing habits and the forces that are being applied over the teeth. Considering this, the implants are the first best option for any prosthesis. So, thank you.